Today we are going to discuss about some possible toolbox for classification of signals and a system. So first let us see the first toolbox. Here state any two properties of unit impulse function. Okay, so for this question you can have two different kinds of properties. One is shifting properties and another one is replication property. Okay, shifting property. So for continuous time, here I'll using the integration part. So for continuous time, I using here integration. Okay, so here integration with respect to minus infinity to infinite x of t. This is your original signals. Okay, input signal. Along with this is unit impulse function. So I take down del of t. For shifting property, so our del of t, it will be shifted into t time, t dot times. So del of t minus t naught. So here all this integral term with respect to t, so I put here dt. So now this is your LHSI. So LHSI is integral minus infinity to infinite for input signal multiplied with unit impulse function by delay unit impulse function, okay, with respect to t. So which is equal to x of t naught. Which is equal to x of t naught. So in this expression integration term here, which one is shifted sequence? Can anyone answer the question? Which part is shifted sequence here? Yeah, del of t minus t naught. So here your unit impulse function is shifted function by t naught. So t naught means t naught times delay. Okay, so del of t minus t naught, at t naught equal to you can have the signals. So that's why our x of t become here x of t naught. Okay, so this is your unit impulse function x of at t equal to t naught. So here I put t naught. So here you can have the signals. This is del of t minus t naught. Del of t minus t naught. So here zero. So in this portion it represents del of t minus t naught. Okay. Now replication property. So they say integral minus infinity to infinite. Here x of tau del of t minus tau. For our convenient, I will take down here tau. Okay. So t minus t tau into d tau, which is equal to x of t. That means x of t, it is multiplied with del of t, which is equal to x of t. So this is the replication property. It means the convolution of any function with delta function, it leaves that function is unchanged. So this is the important note for you. Okay, let us take the convolution of any function with delta function. Any function, whatever function it may be, but it should be convolved with your del function. So it leaves that the function is unchanged. So same function only you can get. Okay, so x of t is multiplied with del of t, you can get x of t. Okay, so y of t multiplied with del of t, you can get y of t. So whatever function it should be, but convolved with your delta function, you can get that actual original function only. So the function should never change. Okay, so that is the property of unit impulse function. Any doubt in this question? First question. Next thing is, draw the following signals: u of t minus u of t minus t naught. Okay, so you know that this is your unit impulse function, unit impulse function, or unit step or unit sequence. Okay, so u of t, unit step sequence. So this condition is satisfied for when t greater than or equal to zero. When t greater than or equal to zero. Okay, so your unit of step signal u of t equal to 1. So for t greater than or equal to zero, the signal is have amplitude is 1. Otherwise it is zero. Okay, so here the amplitude level is 1. For continuous time, I put here continuous signal here. This is u of t. Next, u of t minus t naught, t minus 10. So it means our signal u of t is start from at t equal to t naught. So listen, so already I told you, you know, So t minus t naught means you just think you compare with equal to 0. So t minus t naught equal to 0, which means t minus t naught is n. So t minus t naught equal to 0. So therefore t equal to 10. So your signal is started at time t equal to 10. Listen. So it means this is nothing but delay sequence or advanced sequence. Compare with this two diagram, we can say this answer. So our unit step signal is start from 0, at t equal to 0. But u of t minus 10 is start from at t equal to 10. So it means it will be delayed by 10 units. There will be delayed by 10 units. This is the delayed sequence, isn't it? Now this is u of t, this is u of t minus t n set. So we just to subtract these two, Listen. When you separate here, at t equal to 0, here signal. Here there is no signal. So 1 minus 0, 1 only. So I put plot together here. At t equal to 5, here there is no, here there is signal. Here there is no signal. So high signal minus low signal, so high is only. So here I put high. Next, at t equal to 10, here there will be signal. But here there is no, here also signal. Okay. So up to this 0, up to this 0. So I draw of t equal to 10. At t equal to 10. Okay. So only this portion of signal only I will get it. Okay. Remaining this portion after 10, here also signal, here also signal. So minus. So 1 minus 1, it becomes 0. So it becomes 0. So only this portion only I will get it from when I subtract u of t minus u of t minus t naught. Okay. So again, I draw this diagram. So u of t minus t naught. Okay, any doubt here in this problem? These are the important two marks for you. Next thing is define of power signal. Define of power signal. Okay, so you all know that power signal definition, right? Since wave in infinite length is called power signal. Wave in infinite length is called power signal. The power signal is not limited in time. If the signal, the power signal is not limited in time, it always exists from beginning to end and it never ends. Look at this statement. It always exists from beginning to end, but it never ends. So this is power signal. Okay. So here the condition for power signal is t lies between 0 to infinite. 0 to infinite. Okay. So here you may add some other terms also for energy and power signals. Okay, some more points. The condition for power signal. What are they? The condition for power signal. Condition for power signal. Here, most of the periodic signals are power signal only. Right, because it is periodicity, obey the periodicity property. So most of the periodic signals are power signal. So energy of the power signal is infinite. Energy of the power signal is infinite. Okay, then only you can have get power signal. So power becomes finite value. Okay, so energy of the power signal is infinite. Okay, then only you can get the power signal. So power should be finite value. Right. So one more thing is definition for power signal. P, which is equal to, you also write, note it down this one, P equal to limit P tends to infinite. Okay, you can allow the period 1 over the period of T, 1 by T, then integral minus T by 2 plus T by 2. So here integral term, it consists of energy signal. So here energy signal is x square of t with respect to dt. So I put here dt. Okay. So this is the definition for this portion is represent power signal. Okay. So power signal limit t tends to infinite 1 over the period of t integral minus t by 2 plus t by 2. X square of t into dt. Okay, so energy of the power signal is infinite. So power definition for power, power is between 0 to infinite. Okay, so this is the definition for power signal. Okay, for this question you have to write down this expression. So this is a very important term, this one, or this condition, or this condition. Okay, next one, condition question, that is how the pulse response of discrete time system is useful in determining its stability and causality. Stability and causality, how the pulse response, so how pulse response is here, impulse response, h of n. Okay, it is useful in determining its stability and causality, because already we discussed about stability property and causality property. So for that property you are using the impulse response only. Okay, h of n, h of k, like that you can use it. Okay, but what is the purpose? Okay, why we using this pulse in this kind of signal, we use it in to determine the stability and causality. So the condition is here, discrete time system is causal if only if h of n equal to 0 or n less than 0 or n less than 0. This is the condition. Okay, if h of n equal to 0 or n less than 0, so if it satisfies this condition, the given system is said to be causal system. Okay, so stability condition is summation k equal to minus infinity to finite mod of h of k always less than infinite, stability. So it obey the De Broglie concept, that is bounded input, bounded output. So the condition for bounded input and bounded output, here you can using here k equal to minus infinity to infinite h of k. So already I told you, for continuous time and discrete time, you can take n or k. So this two notation, it represent discrete time system only. Okay, discrete time, right? So here for stability condition is h of k, stability condition is h of k mod of h of k less than infinite. Okay, discrete, if it is causal based, if h of n equal to 0 or less than 0, okay, we call it as the given system is said to be causal system. Okay, so far we have discussed about four important two marks for you. Now next two mark is find the value of the integral. Find the value of the integral integration minus infinite to infinite e to the power of minus 2t del of t plus 2 into with respect to dt. This is your question. You have to find out this value for this integral term. Okay, so look at this integral term. So in this integral we have the shifting property also, because del of t plus 2, this is the shifting property, isn't it? Delayed sequence. So shifting property of inverse function, it says that already we know in first question we will solve the discuss about the properties of impulse function. Okay, so from the first question we have discussed about the properties of impulse function. I just pick up this property from the first question, right? So integral minus infinity to infinite x of t is multiplied with del of t minus t naught into dt, which is equal to x of t naught. So this is the shifting property of function, you all know that, isn't it? So here t naught, what about t naught? You just compare with this integral term with the given integral term. You just compare it, these two. Okay, when you compare these two integral, you can get a t naught which is equal to 2, a t naught equal to 2, because del of t plus 2, isn't it here? So it means t naught, where t naught equal to 2. So what about x of t? X of t is e to the power of minus 2t, this exponential term, right? Now I substitute this term here. Okay, so now x of t e power minus 2t del of t minus t naught, so here you using del of t plus 2, so which is equal to, okay, and you integrate this one, you can get u to the power of minus 2 t naught, u to the power of minus 2 t naught, because already I told you, okay, already I told you x, whatever the function, it is multiple convolved with your impulse function, you can, the your function is never changed, your function is never altered. Okay, so it is x of t multiplied with del of t minus t naught, means it produces the output is x of t naught only, x of t naught only. So this entire whole term, no need to integral this equation and all. Okay, already we know the result. So you just substitute the result here. It's enough for this question. Okay, so x of t naught, so x of t is e power minus 2t. When you substitute x of t naught, means here at t equal to t naught, you just replace. That's it. That's it. You get up e power minus 2 naught, 2 t naught. Okay, so now e power minus 2 t naught, already t naught will be given. t dot is 2. Now we substitute this t dot here. So e to the power of minus 4. E to the power of minus 4. This will be your answer. If you want to represent in integer term, you use the calci and write out the result here. E power minus 4. Okay? Any doubt here in this problem? Okay, so this is the final result for you. Integral minus infinite to infinite e to the power of minus 2t del of t plus 2 dt, which is equal to e to the power of minus 4. So if they ask find the value of the integral term by using the impulse function, okay, so based upon the property of impulse function, you can easily justify your answer. Okay, otherwise it will take more time for to compute this result. Okay, so based upon the result, you can say within fraction of a second, you can say your answer. Okay, next, sixth question. We move on to the sixth question. Give the relationship between continuous time unit impulse function del of e and step function u of t and ramp function r of t. Okay, so far we have discussed about individual elementary signal only, isn't it? So in previous lecture, we had discussed about unit step function, unit ramp function, unit impulse function, and unit exponential function, then complex exponential, real exponential, sinusoidal function and all. Okay, now in this question, they are asking about, you have to show the relationship between among these three functions. Okay, what are they? Unit step, unit impulse, and unit ramp. Okay, we will give the relationship, no problem. Okay. See, look at this. So differential, that is d by dt of r of t, which is equal to u of t. Okay, d by dt r of t, which is equal to u of t. Okay, when you take differentiation with differentiation of your ramp function, it will give the unit step function. It will give the unit step function. Okay, r of t is the ramp function, ma. U of t is unit step function. Okay, so when you want to get unit function, step function, just you have to take the differentiation of ramp function. Okay, differentiation of ramp function, it will give the unit step function, right? So how you will get this ramp function from this relationship is just ramp function r of t, which is equal to integral. When taking integral on both sides, taking integral on both sides, so integral differentiation should be cancelled out. You can get r of t. So here integral u of t with respect to dt. Okay, so see these two definition. See these two results. Okay, so this is the relationship between ramp and the unit step. Okay, from unit step, from ramp signal, you have to find out unit step means you just take down the differentiation. You just take down the differentiation. Suppose I will give you the unit step function. I will give you unit step function u of t put the table. Now you are going to find out the ramp function. It means you have to just take the integral portion of this one. When you take integral portion of this one, you can get the ramp function. Okay, this is the relation. Next, one more thing is unit impulse functions are also there. Okay, so unit impulse function, how you will get the unit impulse function? You just take the differentiation of u of t. You will take the differentiation of u of t. You can get the del of t. Or how you get the unit function from del function? You just take the integral function. Okay, so you always remember at least any two here. From if you remember these two results, okay, no problem for the. You have to find out this remaining two results. Okay, so just you have to find out. Always remember these two results alone. Okay, this is easiest for you. Okay, so it means differentiation of ramp function, it gives the unit step function. This portion. Okay, differentiation of unit step function, it will give the del function. This is the relationship. Okay, once again I repeat, differentiation of ramp function, it gives the unit step. Differentiation of unit step, it gives the unit impulse function. Okay, so this is the relationship between the unit step, unit function, and ramp function. Right. Next thing is, function, new mathematical and graphical representation of continuous time and discrete time impulse function. Continuous time, discrete time, impulse function. See, mathematical representation, there are you, this is also, you have discussed about in first lecture also. Okay, in first lecture, you have seen what are the possible way for to represent continuous time signal and discrete time signal. Okay, so what are the possible way? So you can represent your signal in terms of mathematical equation. You can represent your signal in terms of graphical equation. You can represent your signal in terms of tabular representation. Okay, tabular form. So these are the various possible way to represent your signal. Okay. So now in this question, what they are asking? Just you give the mathematical and graphical representation for continuous time and discrete time unit impulse function alone. Only one function will be asking. So no problem for us. Okay. Already we know that how to represent all the function signals. Okay. So see. So first continuous function, impulse function. So del graph drawn between del of t versus t at t equal to 0. Your amplitude is 1 because the unit value should be given. So here I will take amplitude level is 1 representation. Okay. For discrete time, here you have to draw del of n versus n. Here you put n. Okay. So del of n versus n. So here the amplitude at del n equal to 0, the amplitude is always 1 here. Okay. So this is the graphical representation. Corresponding mathematical representation. See, this is mathematical representation. So del of n, which is equal to curly braces, okay, open curly braces, here which is equal to 1 for condition n equal to 0. For condition n equal to 0, here the signal is there. Otherwise, 0. Here also, del of p equal to 1, only for p equal to 0. Okay, del of p equal to 0, then t not equal to 0. T not equal to 0, here there is no signal. So del of p value should be 0. For continuous time, you have to write down integral part also. So integration of minus infinity to infinite del of p, del of tau, d tau, which is equal to always 1. You take integration portion of impulse function. Okay, the answer result will be unit, that is 1. Okay, del of tau, d tau, which is equal to 1. So this is the difference between unit impulse function for continuous time and discrete time impulse function. Discrete time impulse function. So next two more. So the difference between causal and non-causal system. Okay. So already we know that causal system and non-causal system. So causal system means it depends on past and present input for computing present output. It means whose output is depend upon present input and past input. That is causal. But non-causal means here it is depend only on past, present, and also future input for computing the present output. Okay, it means whose output is depend upon present, past, as well as future input. Okay, if any one of the output, present output, depend upon future input, means definitely your system become non-causal system. Okay, so your system, it is depend upon only the present past input. It means causal system. So this is the difference between causal and non-causal system, right? So these are the possible important two marks repeatedly asking in your examination, right?